Husserl's Phenomenology, seen through the movie Right Now, Wrong Then by Hong Sang-soo. In a well-known movie, Right Now, Wrong Then, the main character, a nameless movie director, Ham Chun-soo, talks about a painting by a woman he had met by chance, Yoon Hee-jung.
좋아요. 예, 정말 좋아요. 퀄리티가 있다라는 거는 알겠어요. 근데 조금 자기를 위한 작품? 자기 위안을 얻으려고 하는 작품 같아요. 이렇게 용감하게 나가야 되는데 자기 연민 같은 느낌? 그런 느낌이 있어요.
Can we really discern the self-pity that the director is referring to? The main character goes on about this feeling.
그게 나쁜 건 아니죠. 퀄리티는 있어요. 상투적인 게 좀 너무 많이 들어가 있는 것 같아요. 상투적인 게 편하잖아요. 위로받을 때는 예, 상투적인 걸로 받아야 되니까. 무슨 말인지 아시겠어요?
His muse, Yoon Hee-jung, does not want to accept this feeling. She finds his brutal honesty startling. His quick judgment on a work that seems to verge on verbal assault is hard to accept. How can he make such a quick judgment by intuition alone when she couldn't see it herself? And what an audacity to say that it's too conventional. What can be the basis of such a claim? The name Hong Sang-soo can only be understood through the movies he has created. He is a reflection of his movies, and his movies are reflections of his life. He's not a cinematographer who presides over his art. Rather, he's someone who is submerged in his art. He's a director that projects himself into his movies through his actors. The director in this movie represents Hong Sang-soo himself. He can only make movies in which the actor is a reflection of himself. His movies are his life, and his life is also his movies. So, his movies represent his life. This means that the movie's essence only emerges when you plow ahead till the end. And unless you've experienced it for yourself, you can never understand it. In this respect, Hong Sang-soo is an extreme realist. Because of his absolute honesty, his movies at times are difficult to watch. Only those who have the courage to embrace this difficulty can rise beyond the conventional nature of the everyday. Hong Sang-soo calls his courage the energy. This energy is not the same as the act of production or direction. It is a phenomenon that has appeared on its own. Husserl defined the phenomenon as that which is given. It refers to an act of perception that ceases to make judgments on what is not given. It speaks to the fact that we cannot perceive beyond what is present here and now. However, we have the tendency to make baseless assumptions as if though they are self-evident. We believe what we learn from school, heard from the people we know, or seen through the media to be correct because they are objective. However, since they have not been proven nor perceived with sufficient clarity, they're still mere doxa, or opinions that have grown out of our old presuppositions. In this respect, they're only shaky hypotheses. Therefore, arguments about what is not given does not speak the language of our being. Not only that, since discussing what is not present is susceptible to falling prey to prejudices of our time, it can easily generate a discourse about one's life that is based on things that have no bearing on oneself. It is a grave danger. Therefore, we must stay vigilant against doxa and hypothesis and put a stop to our habit of making judgments on things that are not given to us. It is only in our efforts to investigate what is given that we may approach our existence and our world in a meaningful sense. However, that which is given always emerges as that which is present. It can only take the form of here and now. What might appear on your CV or your vision of the future is not something that is given. This is the reason why Hong Sang-soo puts energy in the center of his movie. The conflict in Right Now, Wrong Then speaks to the same issue. Now has to be right so that it can allow for an intuition of what is given, and then has to be wrong so that we may stop making judgments on what is not given. It is said that Hong Sang-soo picks his actors based on their physiognomy. It is because only the actors that express the right kind of energy can perceive the relation between the world that is here and now and life that is here and now and express this understanding in movies and carry out an act that is not acting and produce a movie that is not a movie. At the end of the first episode of the movie, a critic asked Chun-soo,
자, 감독님께 과연 영화란 무엇일까요? 감독님의 감독으로서의 모든 경험들을 거치면서 얻어진 그 영화에 대한 정의, 그 단 하나의 언어는 무엇일까요?
예, 그런 것들을 소리내서 표현하면 말이 되겠죠. 근데 그런 것들은 그냥 그런 말입니다. 보시면은 영화라는 것들도 또 저라는 사람도 또 제가 경험한 모든 것들도 여러분들의 삶도 그런 말들하고는 전혀 상관이 없습니다. 말의 힘? 아니 뭐 그렇게 대단하다고 정말 그렇게 그런 말들을 찾느라고 난리인지 모르겠어요. 저는요 그런 중요한 말이라는 게 있다고 생각하지 않습니다. 오히려 방해가 될 뿐이지.
An effort to find the right word to reify the times gone by can never be more important than staying true to what is here and now, and the quest to find the language of phenomenon of here and now. Such a futile effort is an investigation into what is not given and reduces a living human being into a dead person. In other words, we must objectify ourselves in order to reify ourselves as objects that can be expressed in sterile language. In consequence, the language of then can only be doxa and hypothesis, language that is unclear and confused. In order to prevent such language from entering into his movies, Hong Sang-soo writes the script in the early morning of the day of the shoot, doesn't give his actors the time to practice, nor does he give a title to his movie before release. It is an effort to search for a language that is closest to the energy of being, which is the most important component of the world of art and life. It is his quest to keep away from what is not given, and only investigate what is given. This quest is the essence of the movie. Near the end of the first episode of the movie, a poet who he had met the day before tells him that she's a fan and hands him a collection of her poems as a gift. Inside the book, she writes him a message.
우리 삶의 표면에 숨겨진 것들의 발견만이 우리의 두려움을 이겨내는 길이라는 생각에 저도 공감합니다.
The surface of life is what is given, and what is given is in fact concealed. Hong Sang-soo is trying to convince us that our passion to embrace the phenomenon that can only be understood by our intuition is perhaps the only way to overcome our fears. In other words, every day, at each moment, try to discover something. I believe there is a way, in this world, even against our fears. In the phenomena lies the truth, and the truth is always accompanied by courage. Consolation through corny words or misguided search into what is not given can never resolve the anxiety of the life and pain of the world. In discussing the crisis of European sciences, Husserl argues that a science of a simple fact gives birth to a man who only deals with simple facts. A human being that only deals with sterile facts cannot intuit the phenomenon that bristles with life energy. In discussing natural attitude and phenomenological attitude, he writes, natural attitude is an attitude that is uninterested in the difficulties concerning possibilities of perception, whereas phenomenological attitude is an attitude defined by the perspective on the problems of possibilities of perception. A lot of people do not understand Hong Sang-soo's movies. Likewise, many people do not understand Husserl's philosophy. Accustomed to the natural attitude in the bubble of civilization, we have neglected the study of phenomenological attitude. It is because we have been distanced from a conviction that there exists something that can be gotten through our perception within the limits of our own language. On the surface of the everyday life, inside the mundane place near us, what is needed is the courage and passion to face the riddle of existence. Invariably, we can only affirm the life of energy in the strict dichotomy of right now, wrong then. Inside what is given lies the answer, and what is given, skewed by conventional constellation, is impossible to investigate. In order to see clearly, we must block all interferences. In order to approach a life in the true sense of the word, we must dispense with easy reassurances. The conventional is easy, and the easier it is, the farther from the truth it is. Now is right, then is wrong. Only the energy of here and now can be the weapon to battle the anxiety of life. With this weapon, we should be able to welcome the world and life of here and now with outstretched arms. Bye. Paper Renaissance.